I think Femme Fatale is a character in sort of film noir. So that's a type of film from 1940s to late 1950s. And the Femme Fatale was a character who often ensnared the hero of the film, often used her sex appeal to kind of trap them and make them do bad things. There was nothing good about them, you know, they weren't like nice in any way. And so it presented a very different type of female character than what was seen before.
When Mrs. O'Leary's come, kick the lantern in Chicago town. They say that started the fire that burned Chicago down. That's the story that went around, but here's the real lowdown. Put the blame on me, boy. Put the blame on me.
The Femme Fatale is one of cinema's most enduring, enigmatic, and controversial figures. The archetype has existed for thousands of years across folklore, mythology, and literature, from Helen of Troy to the works of John Keats to Carmilla. But the archetype we know today really cemented its place in popular culture with the emergence of film. In San Francisco. During the 19-teens, radical social change was underway due to women's suffragettes calling for women's rights to vote. Women's traditional roles were questioned, and this moral panic was explored in early silent films. Theda Bara was one of cinema's first femme fatales, as well as one of the most influential. Bara was presented as both sensual yet powerful, a woman who broke up marriages and rejected traditional gender roles. On her roles, Bara states, "I play the vengeance of my sex upon its exploiters. You see, I have the face of a vampire, but the heart of a feminist." But Bara's brand of feminism was ultimately more regressive than progressive. Consistently, her characters serve as warnings to the audience, an almost nightmarish vision of the future in which women venture out of the strict roles set out for them, with Bara positioned as the ultimate symbol of female sin. During the war, women's roles were again changing. While men were away fighting, women took control of their homes, finances, and children. Many went out and sought careers and financial independence. However, once the men came home, a moral panic overtook, with many claiming that the traditional family was under threat.
Do you feel that some girls have too much talent and ability to waste on a home and children?
Yes, I think many girls do. Some girls have a great deal to offer, and they certainly don't make any contribution to the business world, sitting home with their children or cooking dinner for their husbands.
The femme fatales of this time explored these anxieties, especially in film noir.
By the time you get to the 50s, you had this kind of conformity in America where women were expected to be a wife and mother in this perfect home. And the femme fatale didn't fit into that mold at all. And in that sense, she represented a threat because she represented a woman who was taking control of them.
A woman who was kind of the catalyst for all the bad things that happens. You could really put the battery cables on there and jack it up, you know, because you had the visuals of people like Stanwyck, Jane Greer, and Out of the Past. These were women you could feel the coldness of a corpse coming off of them.
You do see a powerful woman in cinema. Unfortunately, the femme fatale often gets killed off by the end, like it's like a holiday for a woman to be powerful. You could see the idea of the woman, the femme fatale, being killed at the end of the film in two ways. On one hand, it's a form of interference by the Hays Code. You know, they don't like this powerful woman, and so they're going to kill her off at the end. On the other hand, some critics have argued that by killing the femme fatale off at the end, we're left with a more powerful image than if she was sent to prison. So the femme fatale sent to prison for a crime she's committed is an image of a woman incarcerated, imprisoned by male society, And out of the two, symbolically, the death is probably the better one if you want to retain that sense of power in the audience's mind.